morning students. Today we are going to proceed with the lesson number 6, lines and angles. So earlier session we have studied about the basic concepts of lines and angles. We have seen in that the lines which intersect are called as intersecting lines. Lines which are never meet each other, those are called as parallel lines. Even what we have seen, the angles and their types. Angles are of different types. We have seen acute angle, obtuse angle, then right angle. We have seen the complete angle, reflex angle, right? All these angles we have seen. Apart from it, a pair of angles also we have seen. So, in pair of angles, we see that adjacent angles, then complementary angles and supplementary angles, right? So, even we have seen a pair, linear pair angles and vertically opposite angles, right? So, linear pair of angles, in that what we have studied, the sum of the linear pair angles is equals to 180 degree. Even the vertically opposite angles, for it, we have seen what? The vertically opposite angles are equal. Equal means their measurements are equal. Suppose these are the two angles, this and this. So what? If I am saying this is 30 degree, then this opposite angle will also 30 degree. Right? So likewise we have seen, even for the vertically opposite angles we have seen a proof, and which is important, which is asked in the exams also. Right? Now let us start all this by using all those things. We are going to start with our exercise 6.1, very first question. I have written the question, you also write it down. So in a question number 1, we have in a figure 6.13, lines AB and CD intersect at O. Dekho, AB and CD intersect at O. If angle AOC plus angle BOE, AOC plus BOE. So this AOC plus BOE is equals to 70 degrees given. Simply in dono ka addition, right? Equals to 70 degree given. And angle BOD equals to 40 degrees given. Find angle BOE and reflex COE, right? BOE. We are going to find out the angle BOE, right? And reflex COE. COE ka reflex hume find out karna hai. So how we will find out? So first of all, we have written in this given part. Given, what is known quantity? Just note down. Right? So angle AOC plus angle BOE is equals to 70 degree. Angle BOD is equals to 40 degree. And to find is what? Angle BOE and reflex angle COE. Now let us see how to do the solution from the given part. See, here angle AOC and angle BOE, their addition is equals to 70 degree. If I know one of them, अगर इन दोनों में से किसी एक का भी हमें पता चला, means the one, if I know the perfectly how much it is, can I find out the other angle? Yes, why not? So let us see, the can we get out of these two any one angle over here whose accurate measurement we get or not? Let us see. See, in angle BOD is 40 degree. So I'll write here angle. This BOD is equals to 40 degree. Just see carefully this figure. So BOD, opposite angle is which one? Angle AOC, right? The whatever the arms of the BOD angle, it extend towards the AOC. See, it should make a cross, right? No. So the cross is made over here there. So here what? This angle AOC is also what? 40 degree. So let us write it down here. Angle BOD is equals to 40 degree. Since angle AOC equals to angle BOD, why? These are vertically opposite angles. Understood this one? As the reason is very important, right? So if you are not writing reason, that means what? You may have copied from somewhere or you may have not understood at all. So this vertically opposite angles, these are two. So what we say in case of vertically opposite angles, those are what? Equal. So equal in maths means what? Agar angle BOD is 40 degree, then therefore angle AOC is also what? 40 degree. Got this one? Right. Now this we got 40 degree. Now can we find out angle BOE? Yes. Out of these two we got one angle. So we will write now angle AOC plus angle BOE is equals to 70 degree. Right? Let us write measurement of angle AOC. So measurement of angle AOC is what? 40 degree. So we will write here 40 degree plus angle BOE equals to 70 degree. Right? So this 40, now let us transpose. So we will get BOE is equals to 70 degree minus 40 degree. So therefore angle BOE is equals to 30 degree. What is this one? How we got this? 30 degree. Now angle BOE we got 30 degree. We know angle BOD 40 degree. Then angle AOC also we know 40 degree. Then angle AOD it should know. Right? We should know na that angle AOD. Why? Why we are finding out that? Because we want to find out angle COE, reflex angle COE. And how reflex angle COE we are going to measure? That the sum of these all angles. Right? Angle AOC plus angle AOD plus angle, we have angle DOB, angle BOE. Right? In sub ka addition means the reflex angle COE. But for that purpose, we should know this angle AOD. So how we will get that? Either COD, see AOC and AOD, these two makes what? These two angles makes, see if I just hide this much part, what I will get? AOC plus AOD, which makes a linear pair angles. Or what you can do? You can have like this angle AOD plus angle BOD. It may also makes a 180 degree. That is what? It makes a linear pair angle. Right? So we will write here either one pair, just take it. Right? So we will write here angle AOD plus angle BOD equals to 180 degree. Why I have written understood? So we will write here because here linear pair angles. Now AOD we don't know. So we will write here angle AOD plus BOD we know, that is 40 degree equals to 180 degree. So let us transpose. So angle AOD is equals to 180 minus 40. Right? So 180 minus 40, how much we will get? Yes, 140. So I'll write here angle AOD Therefore, angle AOD is equals to 140 degree. Got it this one? Now, we got 140 degree angle. Now, let us have the reflex angle COE. How we will get that one? Angle here, it was C name, right? Angle AOC plus angle AOD plus angle BOD plus angle COE. So let us have their addition. AOC we got 40 degree plus AOD we got 140 degree plus BOD we got 40 degree and angle BOE we got 30 degree. Right? What we have done? Here the measurements of these angles we have written. Right? Now we will do addition of it. So after addition, what we will get? 40 plus 40, that is 80. 80 plus 30 is 110, right? And 110 plus 140 is 250. So therefore reflex angle COE is equals to 250 degree. Understood this one? How to solve? The whole sum is finished. Now we will move towards question number 2. Right? 2 is to 3 is given. So I'll just give an idea. You solve it then. Right? Or just we will solve. Let us see. So we'll take a question number 2. So you write it down, that question number 2. Written some question number 2, that in figure 6.14 lines XY and MN intersect at O. So you see XY and MN, these two lines intersect at O. If POY, angle POY is equals to 90 degree, means this measurement is given 90 degree, and A is to B is 2 is to 3. A is to B is 2 is to 3, find angle C. हमें सी तक पहुंचना है राइट. सो वेरी फर्स्ट लेट अस राइट इट डाउन व्हाट एवर वी नो. तो गिवन व्हाट वी हैव, एंगल POY इज इक्वल्स टू 90 डिग्री. देन ए इज टू बी इज इक्वल्स टू 2 इज टू 3. रिटन नाउ टू फाइंड, व्हाट इज टू फाइंड अस, टू फाइंड इज मेजरमेंट ऑफ एंगल सी. Right. So let us have a solution for it. Now just tell me how we will get solution. Now here that A is to B ratio is given. It doesn't mean that angle A is 2 and B is 3. No, it doesn't mean. The ratio is given, that time we are going to take its multiples. Right. So 2x and 3x we will take. So first of all let us find out how much measurement for this angle, angle POX. So that one we will find out first, because those two angles are the part of POX, right? Angle A and angle B are the part of angle POX, right? So first we will find here, and since ray OP stands on XY, right? Therefore what we will write, these two bigger angles, I'm saying this POX, angle POX plus angle POY is equals to 180 degree. Why? Because these are linear pair angles. Linear pair angles. Right? So, linear pair angles written. Reason is very important. Now, let us have that angle POX plus POY, it is already given 90 degree. So, we will put here 90 degree equals to 180. So, therefore, angle POX is equals to 180 minus 90. Understood this one? This 90 I have transposed towards the right hand side. So, we got 90 degree subtracted. So, angle POX is equals to 90 degree. Right. Now, what? These two are the adjacent angles, right? Or we will say these are lying inside the angle POX. So, there what A is to B is what 2 is to 3 is given. That is what A upon B is equals to 2 upon 3. Right? So, we will take a constant X or therefore we'll have A upon B is equals to 2X upon 3X. This multiple we are going to take. Right? Whenever ratio is given at that time. So, 2x and 3x is written. So, that is what? A is equals to 2x and B is equals to 3x. So, putting this, I will write here directly. A is equals to 2x and B is equals to 3x. Multiple B X. ठीक है, multiple written. Now, can we add these two? Yes, because these are the part of angle. Right? So, that's why what we will do here. Therefore, A plus B is equals to how much? 90 degree. Why? Because POX measurement is 90. So, A is 2X and B is 3X is equals to 90. So, it is 5X which is equals to 90 degree. Now, 5 we will transpose. So, 90 divided by 5. So, we will get here X is equals to 5 ones are 5 and 5 8s are 40. Right? So, we got 18 degree. X is equals to 18. Simply X we got. Now, we want that angle A and B, let us write it down from it. So, angle A will be what? It is 2X we have written. No? So, angle A will be 2 into X. So, X value is 18 degree. So, therefore, A is equals to 2X. So, let us put the value of X which is 18. So, therefore, A is equals to 36 degree. Right? Similarly, we will find out B. So, B is equals to 3X. Right? So, 3 into 18. X value 18 we got 54. So, B is equals to 54 degree. Now see children, here we just want to find out angle C. So angle C how we will get? Just the figure is with you, right? The figure is what how? It was? It was like this. The angle B and here was angle C. Now just tell me this angle B and angle C. What kind of angles these are? These are linear pair angles because this ray OX stands on OX, OX stands on this MN. Yes. Right? we will write here that since ray OX stands on line MN, therefore that we will write angle name MOX or XOM. We will write B plus C is equals to 180 degree by linear pair angles. Right? So B plus C. So now B we got 54 degree. So let us write 54 and C we are going to find out. तो 180 डिग्री में से 54 माइनस करेंगे तो C इज इक्वल्स टू 180 माइनस 54 आफ्टर सब्ट्रैक्शन वी गॉट व्हाट C 6 देन 7 माइनस 5 इज 2 126 डिग्री अंडरस्टूड दिस वन सो इन दिस वे वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट द values of the given angles right now the third question we will do that is in the given figure angle POR is equals to PRO then prove that angle PQS is equals to angle PRT now the proof is there we are going to prove it how it is equal right so let us see write it down that sum See student, here we are just going to prove it, right? So, we will first mention its given and to prove part. As I told you in the earlier session that whenever prove that sum is there, that time we are going to write the sum in the three parts, three different parts. That is, the one part is what? Given. As we are doing for the word problems, right? So, given is what? Angle PQR is equals to angle PRQ. Right? This is the one given. Now, prove that. What we are going to prove? So, here we will write to prove. So, what is to prove? Angle PQS is equals to angle PRT. Right? So, let us have that proof now. So, we will here let us write proof. Here now we will not write solution. Here we will mention that it is a proof. Right? Now, let us have this proof. What do you see? What are you able to see in the figure? Here these markings are the given part. Right? Now, just individually if we see that, see, this ray PQ is stands on ST, right? Line ST. So, what kind of angles? These two. So, this angle and this angle, these two are what kind of angles? Linear pair angles. So, we will write here, since ray ST, sorry, ray QP stands on ST. The whole line, right? No? Stands on line ST. Line ST. Therefore, these two pairs, right? So, I'll write here name of the angle. Angle PQS plus angle PQR is equals to 180 degree and write it down the reason here first write it down this is as the first statement and then reason write it down that what linear pair angles Understood this one? Very first statement I have written. Similarly, here, this side. See? That PR ray extends on PR stands on ST, again line segment ST. So we will mention here that, see, and these two angles, this and this, it makes what? Linear pair angles. So we will write here ray RP. See, I am just writing the name of the ray from the initial point towards extending. So RP stands on ST, line ST, right? So we will write here, therefore angle PRT plus angle PRQ is equals to 180 degree. Label it as a second one, and this is also what? Linear pair angles. Right, now see carefully the first and the second one. What do you find over there? See, the because of equal to sign, we have the two sides, right? One is the LHS and another is RHS. For both the equations, what we have, the RHS side we have 180 degree 180 degree, right? So what we will say, if the RHS is equal for both the equations, then we will say left hand side is also equal. So we'll write here from first and second, what we have, as RHS is equal, therefore angle PQS plus angle PQR equals to angle PRT plus angle PRQ. Understood this one? How I have written? As the RHS is equal, 180 degree, 180 degree, both of them have. That's why we will write LHS is also equal. Got it? Now, the whatever we have written here, see carefully now. This PQS and PQR. Written. Now, in the given part, what do we have? PQR is equals to PRQ. Right? So, I will write here that wherever PQR is there, that one I will change into what? PRQ. Right? So, we will write, therefore, angle PQS plus angle PRQ. Which is equals to angle PRT plus angle PRQ. Any one of them just change it. So this one I have changed. Now see, left hand side PRQ, right hand side also PRQ. So we will cancel out, because after transposing, those will get automatically cancelled. So what is left? Therefore, angle here, reason write it down, that given. Means, why we have this written? Because in the given part it is mentioned. That's why we have written. So, reason we have to give over there. So, given is written. PQS is equals to angle PRT. Dekho, to prove jo pucha tha, that one we got. So, we will write, hence, proved. Shall I repeat it again? See, I will just repeat the whole sum again. The question is what? Angle PQR is equals to PRQ, which is the given part. Then prove that angle PQS is equals to angle PRT. So, from the given figure, from the given statements, I have written here given part. To prove, प्रूव दैट जो कहा था, सो दैट वन आई हैव रिटन हियर पीक्यूएस इक्वल्स टू पीआरडी. नाउ प्रूफ जो स्टार्ट करना है, सो फॉर दैट प्रूफ व्हाट वी हैव रिटन बाय ऑब्जर्वेशन हियर द फिगर विच वी ऑब्जर्व फ्रॉम दैट वी कम टू नो दैट दिस रे पीक्यू इट स्टैंड्स ऑन एसटी लाइन सेगमेंट राइट लाइन एसटी दिस स्टैंड्स सो बिकॉज ऑफ इट व्हाट लीनियर पेयर एंगल्स आर फॉर्म. तो व्हेन वी आर टेकिंग सी लाइकवाइज इट इज देयर नो सो दिस एंगल एंड दिस एंगल इट फॉर्म व्हाट लीनियर पेयर दैट्स व्हाई दीज टू एंगल्स आर टेकन. तो एंगल पी क्यू एस प्लस एंगल पी क्यू आर टेकन विच इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री बिकॉज लीनियर पेयर एंगल्स दैट इज लेबल्ड एज वन. सिमिलरली ऑन द अदर हैंड साइड हियर दिस साइड व्हाट वी हैव दिस एंगल एंड दिस एंगल इट मेक्स व्हाट लीनियर पेयर एंगल्स. सो आरपी स्टैंड्स ऑन दैट एस टी लाइन सो पी आर टी प्लस पी आर क्यू इक्वल्स टू 180 डिग्री एंड लीनियर पेयर एंगल्स रिटन. इफ यू सी फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड केयरफुली दैट वी कम टू नो दैट राइट हैंड साइड इज इक्वल 180 डिग्री एंड 180 डिग्री दैट्स व्हाई व्हाट वी हैव डन लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इज ऑल्सो इक्वल. गुड तो लेफ्ट हैंड साइड वी हैव रिटन इक्वल. इक्वल मीन्स वी आर गोइंग टू पुट इक्वल टू साइन इन बिटवीन. तो एंगल पी क्यू एस प्लस एंगल पी क्यू आर इक्वल टू एंगल पी आर टी प्लस पी आर क्यू. नाउ वी नो दैट वन इन द गिवन पार्ट इट इज गिवन पी क्यू आर इज इक्वल टू पी आर क्यू. आइदर यू चेंज पी आर क्यू टू द पी क्यू आर और पी क्यू आर टू द पी आर क्यू. ओनली वन वन एंगल यू आर गोइंग टू चेंज राइट. तो व्हाट आई हैव डन हियर पी क्यू आर आई चेंज एंड रिटर्न पी आर क्यू बिकॉज बोथ आर इक्वल राइट. तो पी आर क्यू एंड पी आर क्यू ऑन बोथ द साइड्स वी गॉट सो दैट्स व्हाई वी कैंसल्ड आउट. तो एंड रीजन राइट इट डाउन गिवन इन द गिवन पार्ट वी गॉट दिस वन दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव रिटर्न. नाउ व्हाट इज लेफ्ट एंगल पी क्यू एस रिटर्न इक्वल्स टू साइन and PRT is remaining and which is the required proof right. means humne kya kiya yahan par from the given part we have just reached up to the to proof right. the final statement we have written hence proved. got it. in the similar way just solve the question number 4 right. in the question number 4 we are going to prove it that ki xy suppose if xy and equals to w plus z x plus y is equals to w plus z then prove that angle AOB is a line. So question number 4 from exercise 6.1 which we are going to discuss only where you are going to do as an homework. I am going to explain you how to do it. So in figure 6.16 if x plus y is equals to w plus z then prove that AOB is a line. Is this clear that what to write in a given and what to write in a proof? Right? To prove. So given is what will be our x plus y is equal to w plus z. So we will first here note down given is equal to what? That x plus y is equal to w plus z. This is our given. Now then prove that. So to prove we will write to prove that AOB is a line. AOB is a line. Right? To have a line, AOB as a line, we are just going to reach up to what? This AOB measurement is what? For which angle we are getting as a line only? Simply a straight line. For which angle? Yes, you are correct that for when we are getting a straight line, so that time that line or the measurement is what? 180 degree. Right? Means this measurement we should know, we should show that AOB is equals to 180 degree. Is that clear? Means from this we are going to reach up to 180 degree. So how we will get 180 degree? See here around the point O, right? This middle point. So what is the total measurement? What will be the total measurement? Equals to 360 degree, right? So what we will write? X plus Y plus Z plus W is equals to 360 degree. Then what? From the given what we know? X plus Y. So X plus Y को club कर दो and W plus Z just club it. Now what we will write? As we have done in earlier question that X plus Y equals to W plus Z. So any one replace it, right? So when we will replace, so we will get twice of X plus Y or twice of W plus Z. So that we are going to transpose. So 360 divided by 2, we will get 180, right? So as we got 180, means what? AOB is a line. Got it this one? So in this way, you are going to do question number 4 as an homework. Got it? Now, we will start with the question number 5. So question number 5 we will write. You also write it down that question number 5. See here, how to solve the question number 5. In the question number 5, it is given that angle POQ is a, POQ is a line. POQ. Then ray OR is perpendicular to line PQ. OR is perpendicular, means it makes a 90 degree angle ROQ and angle ROP. OS is another ray lying between the rays OP. OS. This OS is the another ray which is lying in between the OP and OR. This ray OP and OR. To prove that angle ROS, this middle ROS is equals to half angle QOS minus angle POS. This we are going to prove. Right? So first of all, we are going to prove it, no? So first we will write a given part. So what is given over here? We'll write POQ is a line. POQ is a line. Now ray OR is perpendicular to line PQ. So we will write like this. See, ray OR or ray OR. This sign is perpendicular sign, right? Perpendicular to line PQ. Then OS is another ray lying between rays OP and OR. So we will write OS lying between rays OP and OR. Rays OP and OR. Right? Now, what is to prove? To prove that. So, we will write here to prove angle ROS is equals to half of angle QOS minus angle POS. Right here below. See, angle ROS is equals to half of angle QOS minus angle POS. Hey. Whenever to prove that sum is there, at that time, as I told you, that when we are writing given to prove and then proof, it is compulsory because the marks are distributed as per it. So given, it carries one mark, then to prove also carries one mark, or both of this as per the question, it contains the marks, half of marks also. So given to prove and then prove that, right, to prove. So we will write now proof. From the given information, we are just going to have a proof. So, what is the given information over here? See, ray OR perpendicular to line PQ. Right? So it is perpendicular means the angle ROQ and angle ROP or POR is equals to 90 degree. So we will write here angle ROQ or I'll write QOR. It is QOR is equals to angle POR which is equals to 90 degree. Right? This information we are getting from the given. So we'll write here first given. Then one more information we are getting from the figure, that is angle QOS is equals to, how this angle QOS is formed? See, this QOS, it is nothing but the combination of two angles. So we will write here angle QOS is equals to angle QOR plus angle ROS. QOR plus angle ROS. This one we will label it as first statement. Right? This we have written from the figure. Similarly, or you can label it as this is 1 and this is 2 also. See, now POS, this angle, simply POS, this angle how does it form? It is nothing but angle POR. From that, if you subtract this angle ROS, we just want to find means POS. Now another statement I am writing here, angle POS is equals to, this angle is how does it form? That angle, from whole angle POR, from that if we subtract the middle angle, that is ROS, subtract angle ROS, so what we will get? Angle POS. Got it? We are just, see here in this side we are looking, so this angle we have written POS, so PO and this is here R and this is S, right? So P, for getting POS, what we are going to do, from whole POR we are going to subtract this angle. If I remove this angle, so what I will get finally? POS. That's why I have written here, this is label it as second. Now just pay attention towards what is to prove. We want ROS. Do we got here in both the statements, do we got ROS? Yes. Then we want QOS and POS as well. So QOS we got and POS is also we got here. So we want their subtraction. Half we will bring, how it will bring? I will tell you. But first concentrate over here. QOS minus POS. QOS minus POS means what? We are going to subtract second from 1. If we subtract, so for that purpose we will write here subtract second equation from first, or we will write here subtracting second from 1. So let us subtract. So this POS, first we will write from 1, no? So angle QOS, so from first we are subtracting. So QOS we will write first and then minus angle POS. From 1, no? So first wala statement jo hai, so first likhenge left side. While subtracting also, left side mein se left side subtract karna hai and right side se right side. So right side is angle QOR plus angle ROS minus I'll write in a bracket angle POR minus angle ROS. Is that clear? See. Right. So subtraction sign I have written outside. Now your angle QOS minus angle POS is equals to this side. Minus sign is outside the bracket, which will change the sign inside the bracket. So angle QOR plus angle ROS plus angle POR, sorry, here minus, it will be minus angle POR and plus angle ROS. Now see carefully that we have here written angle QOR is equals to angle POR, which is equals to 90 degree. Now before the first statement, we have written here angle QOR is equals to angle POR, which we are getting from the given part. So wherever we have QOR, we are just going to replace it by POR, right? So we will write angle QOS minus angle POS equals to this QOR, I am going to replace by angle POR. Why? Because in the given, or I have written here earlier statement in the proof, that is equals to POR, right? So that's why I have changed angle ROS minus angle POR plus angle ROS. See, now what? This POR and POR will get cancelled because one having positive sign and another having negative sign. The opposite signs will get cancelled. Now ROS, ROS has got two times. So we will write twice of angle ROS. Right? Now here the remaining part QOS minus angle POS. Now what? See, in to prove, we got angle ROS, we got one side, angle QOS minus angle POS, that one also we got. We don't want these two towards ROS. We are going to shift it towards left side. So this is multiplied, so it will be divide. So 1 upon 2 into, we'll write here angle QOS minus angle POS, which is equals to angle ROS. So I'll just shift the sides so that angle, therefore angle ROS is equals to half of angle QOS minus angle POS, and we'll write hence proved. Understood this one? How to solve or how to do the proof, right? What we have done, the given, from the given part we have written that is angle QOR is equals to POR, which is equals to 90. Why 90? Because the ray OR is perpendicular, that's why it is 90 degree. Then from the figure we have written QOS is equals to angle QOR plus angle ROS. That one will be the first one. Then angle POS is equals to, again we have written from the given part, from the figure, POS we got POR minus ROS. Always pay attention towards what is to have, means hame kya chahiye, right? To prove me kya chahiye. So means according to that we are going to try to frame the statements. Got it? So POS, now if we see carefully, if I subtract these two, I'll get that QOS minus POS. So that's why we subtracted 1 and 2. So from we have subtracted 2 from 1. So accordingly write it down. So QOS minus POS, and this is angle QOR plus angle ROS. So left side subtract karni, right side se right side subtract. So while subtracting this, we have to write in a bracket because whenever minus sign comes, it changes the sign. So that's why. See, here earlier it was minus sign inside the bracket. When I open the bracket, that time we change into plus sign. Now this QOR is equals to POR because this is what from where we have written from the given. You can write here reason given. Hey, here given, write it down as, or you can here simply mention since angle, instead of writing here, you can simply mention here angle QOR is equals to angle POR. Therefore, these statements QOR we have replaced by POR. So POR, POR get cancelled because opposite signs we got. ROS, ROS two times we got. That's why two times ROS written. Now two we will transpose because the requirement is what? ROS on the one side. So two we have shifted. It becomes divide. So in this way we got the required proof. Understood? Now the question number 6. Write it down, that question number 6, and we will try to solve it. Okay, alright. We have written the question number 6. You might have written the question number 6. I'm thinking that this question you are going to solve. I'm just going to guide you. See, it is given that angle XYZ is equals to 64 degree and XY is produced to point P. So from the given information, we are going to draw a figure, right? So very first, what we will do here, that angle XYZ is equals to 64 degree, we are going to draw. 64 means exactly 64 we don't want to, just approximately we are drawing, no? So angle X, Y, Z. Now produce to point P, draw a figure from the given information. So this, from this it produce a one point P. So for that what is given? If ray YQ, तो हमें YQ bisects ZYP, हमें इस तरह से फिगर निकालनी है, right? तो we will first we will draw accordingly. So I'll here P is produced, no? So we will here P will produce here X, Y, Z. So X, Y, Z. Written. P is produced from A. So Z, Y, P. Y, Q is bisects Z, Y, P. So Z, Y, P. This is the angle we got. So to this, Y, Q means bisect. Bisect means what? It makes two equal parts. So we will write here Q. Is that clear? How we have drawn the figure? Now, what we are going to find? Angle XYQ. Find means no proof. So we are just going to find angle XYQ. This is first. And second, what we are going to find? Reflex angle QYP. Right? This is, we are doing solution. See, the figures are very important. Whenever, means in the geometry, the figures are there. Whether it is already it is given in the question or we are supposed to draw in the answer part. Answer means solution part. The figures have to draw, right? Now from this given we are going to find XYQ and reflex QYP. QYP, this reflex we are going to find. The reflex, you know, Likewise, you are going to solve it. I am not going to solve it. See, I will only tell you how to solve. Angle XYZ, XYZ. I'll write the given part. That is, this is 64 degree. Now, what is we are going to reach up to XYQ. XYQ. How we will get XYQ? We don't know rest of the measurements, right? Apart from this XYZ, we don't know any measurement. But what we know that angle XYZ plus angle ZYP. If you do addition of these two angles, it will be what? 180 degree. Right? Why? Because it is a linear pair angle. Right? So, dekho, ZYP and XYZ, if you are getting is equals to means, you will get from it ZYP angle you will get. So, I will give you the steps, means what to do exactly in this question. So, I will write here solution and you are going to solve it accordingly. Listen student, I am not solving, only just I am telling you what to first find. So, I will write here find angle ZYP. How we will find ZYP? By taking linear pair angles. So, ZYP plus XYZ is equals to 180 degree. Right? So, we will write here. Then, second step. Once we got angle ZYP, then what we will do? From ZYP, if you wait a minute. Then one more information it is given that we know that this QY or YQ bisect angle ZYP. So whatever angle we have got, so that angle now we will write here for the second step. What you are going to find? That since angle ZYP is bisector or YQ is a bisector, therefore angle QYZ you will get something, right? Or shall I solve it? We will solve. See, I will here continue. What I am trying to say, please try to understand over here. Angle XYZ plus angle ZYP is equals to 180 degree because linear pair angles. Right? So, let us write it down, their measurement over here. So, XYZ is 64 degree plus angle ZYP is equals to 180 degree. So, 64 we will transpose. So, we will get ZYP is equals to 180 minus 64 degree. So, angle ZYP is equals to 116. Right. So, after subtraction we got. Now, what we know, in the question it is given, YQ, ray YQ, bisect angle ZYP, therefore, we'll have that angle XYQ we are going to find, no? So, we should know this. Angle QYZ or ZYQ equals to bisector. So, it makes it two equal parts. So, angle ZYP divided by 2. Understood this one? So, 116 divided by 2, which is equals to 2 5s are 10 and 2 8s are 16. So therefore, angle ZYQ equals to 58 degree. Right? Now, this we got 58 degree. Now, is it, are we able to find that angle XYQ now? Yes. Angle ZYX or XYZ plus angle ZYQ, you will get angle XYQ. So, find out. Now, rest of the sum you are able to solve, no? Angle XYQ is equals to angle XYZ plus angle ZYQ. So, XYZ we know 64 degree. And this we got 58 degree. Do the addition and write it down, that answer. And you find out now reflex angle. Reflex QYP you find out. Your addition is what? 8 plus 4 is 12. 6, 6, 12. 122 degree. Right? So 122 degree we got angle XYQ. Right? You find out now reflex angle. And how to find out reflex angle? I have told you in the earlier question. Right? So, reflex is QYP. All this. This angle you know. This angle you know. What about the downward side angle? It is a straight line, no? So, it is 180 degree. So, 180 plus 64 plus 58, you will get angle QYP, reflex angle QYP. You solve it as an homework, that one. Understood? So, the exercise 6.1 is over. What I am telling you, that one, solve the all questions again and try to understand it. If you are not getting, just ask me those queries in a dub session then.